In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to quickly turn a daytime photo into a nighttime scene using only Lightroom. Recently, I was in Liverpool when I spotted this great shopfront. It was the mid-afternoon, but the scene in my mind was of a dark street and a shop lit by a neon sign. Let me show you how easy it is to make this transformation using only Lightroom. This is the starting RAW file, straight out of camera, without any adjustments. My first step is to reduce the exposure of the image using the exposure slider in the basic panel. I just pull this left until the scene looks very dark. Ideally, I want the histogram to be gathered over on the left side. The other change that I want to make is to the colour temperature of the image to cool it down. All I need to do is move the temp slider so that the scene takes on a blue hue. My next adjustment is an optional one using the tone curve. There I'll add a point to the centre of the curve and then pull it down to darken the image further. After that, I'll add a point in the highlights which I'll pull up to lighten them. This helps to prevent the neon lights from becoming too dark in the image. Whilst I could have made these changes in the basic panel, I prefer to use the curves tool. I think it produces a more natural, nighttime effect than using only the basic controls. Now that my image looks like it was shot at night, I can work on adding some lighting effects using the Lightroom masking tools. Most of my changes for this image are going to be made using the simple radial gradient. My next selection is to the side of the shop, next to the neon sign to make it appear that the sign is lighting that. After clicking the masking icon, I'll click the radial gradient option in the list to select it. Now I can click and drag with my mouse at the point where I want to add the selection. When I release my mouse, you can see the radial gradient in position. Now even though I've placed my selection on the image, I can still click and drag with the controls using my mouse to resize and reposition it. Now it's time to create the effect of light by increasing the exposure slider. Along with the exposure slider, I'll also increase the temp slider to warm the light so that it's more attractive. It really is as simple as that. Now let's repeat this, but for the neon sign on the door. I'll click the icon in the mask panel to add a new mask. After that, I can click to use the radial gradient tool again. As before, I just click and drag with my mouse to produce the gradient. When the gradient's in place, I can make my adjustments. I'll increase the exposure as I did before and then warm the light using the temp slider. Now let's use the same technique to light the pavement in front of the shop. Click the new mask option in the mask panel and then choose the radial gradient from the list. This time when I draw with the radial gradient, I'll rotate it slightly to keep it in line with the pavement. Of course, I can always refine this afterwards if I need to. Now I can increase the exposure to give the feeling of light. After that, I'll increase the temperature slider to give the feeling of a warm street light. Now let's add a new mask to light the shop front using the radial gradient again. I'll click and then drag to draw the radial gradient so that it covers the front of the shop. Then I can increase the exposure slider, followed by the temp slider. I'm sure you're already spotting the pattern to what I'm doing here, so let's vary it a little. This time, I'm also going to pull the shadow slider to the right as well. I'm doing this to open the shadows in the windows because they're too dark. By using the shadow slider, it makes it look like the light is on and you can see inside the shop. Now let's add one more mask with the radial gradient, this time to select the light in the upstairs window. I'll increase the exposure, followed by the temp slider to give the appearance of a warm light. Then I'll use the shadow slider to make it appear that the light is lighting inside the room. Something else that I can do is use the highlight and white sliders to increase the intensity of the light. At this point, the lighting in the image is looking good, but we're seeing too much of the surrounding buildings. I'm finding the white wall on the building next to the shop particularly distracting. To fix this, I'm going to go back to my global adjustment tools. Then using the effects panel, I want to add a vignette. When I drag the amount slider there to the left, it creates a dark vignette around the image, making the shop lighting stand out even more. Despite this, the white of the wall is still distracting. I can therefore go back to my masking tools where I'll add a linear gradient. Using this, I can click and drag with my mouse so that the gradient covers the white wall and part of the tattoo sign. Now I just need to move the highlight slider to the left until the white wall almost vanishes. After making these adjustments, an important final step is to go through each of the masks in turn to adjust and fine-tune how they work together. This is easy to do by moving the amount slider left and right. It allows me to change the strength of the effect of each mask without needing to change the settings that I used. It's a great way of making the different changes all blend and hang together. Now compare the starting daylight image with the adjusted nighttime image, and you can see it's a complete transformation. This is only possible because of the excellent masking and selection tools we now have in Lightroom. In this video, I demonstrate how to select and blur a distracting background using these tools. It's a great one to watch next. Thanks for watching today, and if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you soon for another video.